Yes, indeed.
Welcome.
Here for a show?
Can I buy a ticket, please?
Please, through those double doors.
Hello! Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you. I am your host, Aldridge T. Abington. Thank you. Yes, Aldridge T. Abington. Few men have had a career more crowded with incident and various intercourse with the world than I. I discovered this next act in a tiny village in Italy. Truly the most exotic of places in the world. He was just a 10-year-old boy. I raised him. I bathed him. I shaved him from head to toe.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to my incredible display of dark arts and mystical prowess, my dear ladies and gentlemen. A man cannot outrun a bullet. Many fools have tried and failed in this endeavor, including the tonic salesman I caught petting my wife.
I joke.
To prove that these are indeed live rounds, if my sharpshooting assistant would be so kind as to shoot this bottle of Lalicola off my head.
Okay. Oh my God, it's a lot.
My leg. This is a bunch of dang balderdash.
Oh, damn.
A strip
with the show.
Hmm?
I'm trying to watch the show.
And Benjamin Lazarus, I assure you, I am not participating in some hoax or carnival ruse. These bullets are 100% real.
Wow.
In fact, I challenge any member of the audience to come forward with their own firearm, and I will yet again display my uncanny skill to catch a bullet in my teeth.
Did you hear that?
Is no one man enough? Come on, someone, stand up and take a shot.
Okay, okay. If nobody else is gonna expose this phony, then I will.
Oh, knock his teeth out.
Now, I discovered this next remarkable woman in a lost jungle. She does emit fire from almost every orifice in her body.
This lady is spooky.
Woo! Damn, this show is something else.
Incredible, bravo, though I must warn you, court her at your peril. She'll not nurse babies, she'd turn them into bacon. Thank you. He liked that joke, yes.
Hello, thanks for joining us today. This here is a new song about a so-called modern improvement you may have become aware of called the telephone.
Hello, my baby, hello, my honey, hello.
What a fine tune! Thank you for joining me for tonight's entertainment. Dream well, and come back soon.
Yep.
Let's get.
That's the wrong.
Yep. Yep.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Hold up there a moment.
What brings you to this fine town? Profit and pillage?
Just minding my own business.
You looking for a volley of musket fire?
Stick 'em up, cowboy.
Hey, can I get a drink here?
I'll get washed away.
I'll get you in a second. Dollar, please.
For a whiskey?
Oh, that's the real stuff. From Scotland.
Okay. Here, have one for yourself.
Why, thank you.
So, mister, can I ask you a question? You ever hear of a fella by the name of Bronte?
Who's asking?
Me. I'm asking.
No, leave it, Fred.
What do you mean, leave it?
Look, I don't know what business you in, but leave it, Fred. You and your pal that was in here before.
Angelo Bronte. Mr. Big, Mr. Italian spaghetti-eating long streak of piss big. And he makes my skin crawl. I'm so swallowing your cocksucker. You know what I mean, friend?
Where can I find him?
Oh, well, I reckon you talk to them kids in the alley. They'll know, I guess.
Come on now, this sulking doesn't become you.
You always have to be right, don't you?
I'm just giving you the correct use of the word. If you're feeling sick, you're not nauseous, you're nauseated.
Right, you're nauseous and I'm nauseated.
You're impossible.
Pardon me, but have you seen any kids around this way?
Yeah, I think I heard a few in the other courtyard up ahead. You can get through on the left there.
So are you done with the silent treatment now?
No. Hey, you got a cigarette, mister?
Maybe.
Huh?
I'm looking for a fellow named Angelo Bronte. Italian.
I know him. Everyone knows him.
Where is he?
We'll take you to him. What it'll cost.
I reckon I can pay.
$5.
Where does he live? New York?
I'm an entrepreneur. If you don't want to pay, then I don't want to walk.
That's Baird and Schreiber on the right there. Famous bookstore. Not that I'm much of a reader myself. Now over here's a real piece of art. That's the Church of the Holy Blessed Virgin, mister.
My mama said they used to burn Protestants and all, but we all friends now.
Bet they don't have nothing so fine where you come from, mister. Look at them fine steeples.
Hey, you little pair of shit.
Let's go. Yeah, that fellow looks angry. Bye, mister. I'm being chased by the village idiot. I'll spend it on something nice, mister, I promise.
Stop, you shit.
You all right back there, old man?
You better stop right now. Bastard got off.
Ah, damn street trash. You after that kid? How the shit went that way?
You know, I kind of miss old Bob Tales.
I don't. Bounce around so much, couldn't even read the newspaper.
Remember when they had to bring the mules back out after the snowstorm in 95? Couldn't get the ice off the trolley wires?
Technology. All well and good so long as it works.
You all right there?
Hey, you see a kid about 14 years old run through here?
Why, yes, we did. He went around the corner there.
Damn snitch! Bye, mister! Just give it up, farm boy!
Get back here!
Come on, run like the goats got loose! You ain't got a chance in hell, slowpoke!
Good morning.
Hey, partner!
Hi!
I'm telling you, a cucumber's definitely a fruit!
Since when?
Since forever. I read it in the newspaper.
Oh, so it must be true. So they tell you your dog's a cat now, you just start calling him Mittens.
That ain't really the same thing.
Facts. They make half of them up.
Fellas, you seen a kid come through here? About 14, 15?
Oh, yeah, he ran right through us. Ran around the corner there.
So let's just agree to disagree on the cucumber.
If you want to disagree with the two, that's your choice.
Good morning, kids. I've
seen everything. Being outside in
the weather. Give me my things, boy.
What are you talking about, friend?
I ain't your friend. But that kid is, and he robbed from me. Now, give me back my stuff and take me to Angelo Bronte.
Senor Bronte.
That kid was going to show me before he robbed me.
I know you got some money.
Get yourself some real food, huh?
I lost my money playing poker. I know where a good game is. Above the gunsmith.
Rio? Hush, hush.
Sorry.
How do you do, sir?
Grabbing life, taking a bite. Hey.
Partner?
Howdy.
Arthur! Where you been?
Getting robbed.
Who by?
Bunch of children.
I won't inquire anymore.
But I found Mr. Bronte. Seems to be some Italian Mr. Big in town. Everybody knows him, but nobody wants to talk about him.
Hey, buy me a drink, mon ami, huh?
Sure, what you want?
Brandy.
Two brandies, bud.
It's $2 a glass.
Oh, better be good then.
It's the best.
Thank you. Santé. It's quite a country you're building here, eh?
Well, me personally?
I don't know. What do you do?
Mostly, I just shoot people.
How very American of you. I love it.
What do you do?
Oh, mostly I pose, I show off, I complain.
Oh, how very French.
I know. I am ridiculous.
Arthur.
Charles. You know, Arthur, don't believe in art. It's lies. Believe in women. They are the truth. Art is lies, but the vagina, that is truth. Breasts is truth. Art. So it is.
If you say so.
Oh, trust me, I've tried both. One is better. Much better.
You're about to witness true justice in action. When a beautiful young lady ridiculed your disfigurement.
Disfigurement?
You murdered her in cold blood. For your awful vanity and pride, you will pay.
Oh, you are right. Please remember me, friend.
As you live.
Tell me out again.
Any last words before the noose?
That ugly bitch deserved what she got.
She deserved it.
Seems ironic, huh?
Pull.
Oh, there he goes. I heard the neck snap. Damn. Cruel and abhorrent behavior will not stand in this country.
See his legs twitching.
Justice won this battle, but the war is far from over. Heed these words.
Bravo!
Kinda makes me hungry watching that.
I know what you mean. It's the blood boiling. Makes me feel alive.
Exactly. I can go for some crawfish.
This seems like a decent town.
Really?